The history of Punch and Judy can be traced to 16th century Italy, with the character descending from the Italian clown Pulcinella. He was featured in the Commedia dell'arte. Players toured Europe, and at one of these shows in May 1662, Samuel Pepys was witnessed during the festivities surrounding the wedding of Charles II in Covent Garden. These shows took off in London and became very popular under the name Punchinello. This is eventually shortened to Mr. Punch, as we know today. The moral story was taken up by puppeteers as it could be used to comment on the politics of the day. By 1800, Punch gained wife Judy, among others, and the show began to take on more British theatrical traditions. As performing in towns became more difficult, Mr. Punch travelled on the newly built railways to the seaside, where he entertained the British working class as they took their holidays. One of these seaside shows is the Codman's Punch and Judy show in Llandudno. The show has been running for over 150 years under the same family. We spoke to Jacqueline Codman, who runs the show, to find out more. Firstly, we asked Jacqueline, what can you tell us about the history of Punch and Judy in Llandudno?
Well, it was all started by my great-grandfather. Now, he was an itinerant musician and he used to travel round everywhere. He'd actually got married by the time he arrived at Llandudno, and he came with in his caravan with his wife. But when he arrived here, one of the horses died, so he couldn't go any further. Now, he had been travelling around, as I say, he'd been doing fairs, weddings, funerals. He was a brilliant musician, apparently. And one of the horses died. So on his travels, an old professor had shown him the basics of Punch and Judy. And so he's seen, and it's actually mentioned in our archive somewhere, so a historian told me, that he was seen walking the beach every morning, and they didn't know what he was doing, but he was gathering driftwood. And the dolls that we use today, which is Punch and Judy here, and we've another set, and the proscenium, which is on the show, which is the heavily carved, he carved from driftwood off our beach from here. And that's how Punch and Judy started in Llandudno.
Tell us about your version of Punch and Judy and how it differs from others.
Well, the basic story of Punch is always the same, because that goes back to Samuel Pepys, you see. Now, the first mention of Punch and Judy in this country was on May the 9th, 1662. And Samuel Pepys had actually gone to watch an execution of a lord. But this executioner was so bad that he took two or three goes. And as I say, he reported in his diaries that this lord managed to say, after the second blow of the axe, "I've paid you handsomely, be swift." But after this execution, he crossed over it, which it was being, the act had been done in Covent Garden, and saw Punch and Judy. But Punch was outwitting the executioner, Jack Ketch, and everybody was happy because, you see, the people had asked for this executioner not to be the official one, but the authorities wouldn't listen. So when Punch outwitted him, everybody was happy. And that's the way the news was travelled, through the travelling actors. And they were trying to tell everybody, you know, about this dreadful executioner. And but the authorities wouldn't. But he did come to a sticky end himself. The people got rid of him in the end. Yeah.
What's your favourite scene and character?
Well, my favourite character is Mr. Punch. He's beautiful. The Hobbit. But I do like the crocodile scene, because it takes everybody by surprise, where Punch fights with him and takes his stick, and then the sausages come out of his mouth. And also, of course, the crocodile then, which I love my crocodile. He shoots water over the children and they're not expecting it. Yeah. But Judy, she has a very short life on Punch show, because Punch's hit first by all the characters, which many people don't realise. But if you watch it carefully, Judy comes up and hits Punch because he's not treated the baby nicely. So there's a bad fight. So.
In 2010, the Codman family celebrated the 150th anniversary of their show, which also gained a feature on BBC's The One Show. We asked Jacqueline how they celebrated.
Well, believe it or not, Miss Punch and Judy got married. And there was a wedding at the smallest church in Beaux-Saint-Cie, but I always say they were renewing their vows. They had been married, but they renewed their vows in the smallest church in Beaux-Saint-Cie, but also, as I say, it went live on the one show, and we celebrated that way, letting everybody know that we're still here.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Hello there, Jacqueline. Now, we're on some sort of delay now, like Clive James. The fifth member of your family now is involved.
That's my son. That's my son, Jason.
Good name.
And who's the great-great-grandson, and he's got a little treat for you.
Oh.
Lovely.
Let's have a look.
And finally, we also asked Jacqueline if she saw the Punch and Judy show lasting another 150 years.
Oh yes, I'm working on my grandchildren. I keep telling them that they can all be teachers, and then they can be off for the holidays, and they can do it in turn between them.
Yeah,
I think that's it.